Let's take a look below. Our 5G is enabled through a new network architecture and new air interface technology to enable our new key capabilities. The first one is our network architecture. We want to achieve many key capabilities such as low latency. We want to achieve it on our existing network architecture. They might encounter some difficulties, but we can achieve it through some new network architectures. It will be relatively easier, including wanting to implement slicing. That also requires updating our existing network architecture. We also mentioned it yesterday, because the 5G network is defined in the protocol. At the beginning of R15, considering competition, we divided the networking methods into two types. One is non-standalone networking, the other is standalone networking. We call non-standalone networking NSA. At this time, our 5G network is dependent on the 4G network, and they are tightly coupled. Then our signaling plane is on the 4G side. Only user data forwarding is done on the new 5G base station. But the characteristic of the network is we can stand on the 4G network core. That is our EPC, but at this time, because it needs to interface with the 5G base station to recognize some new network parameters. So in fact, EPC, we need to upgrade the software, upgrade it to EPC. Then this is our core network part. Of course, we are based on 4G network equipment. Through software upgrades to gain such capabilities, we don't need to build new another scenario. Is our 4G base station to interconnect with the 5G base station? Then of course the 5G base station to access the 4G core network EPC. At this time, our dual mode terminal below it can access 4G. Then take the 5G base station or 5G cell as an auxiliary station or add an auxiliary cell. In this way, we can achieve higher business rates. Well, this is our NSA non-standalone networking scenario. Actually, we can also see then the dashed line represents our control plane signaling, but we see that signaling all go through the 4G LTE base station access to the core network. Then the green 5G base station of 5G, we see it only has solid lines. In fact, it only did user plane data forwarding. So this is our NSA networking scenario, but it also has some characteristics or some limitations. For example, it only supports the EMBB scenario. We also mentioned this yesterday. Under this NSA networking method, it does not support slicing. That is, it does not support various new vertical industry applications. Another one is that we want to use 4G as an anchor point. Then reuse the 4G core network. Of course, the 4G core network needs to be upgrade to EPC. In addition, in this way, we can quickly introduce 5G. We don't need a lot of capital investment at the beginning of network construction. Can quickly introduce 5G in some hotspot areas. The last point is, in this NSA networking scenario, 5G is superimposed on the 4G network. We don't need to provide continuous 5G coverage. For example, in a city, I don't need to build 10,000 stations or 50,000 stations to achieve this continuous coverage. This is not necessary. In the NSA networking scenario, because we are in some hotspot traffic areas, then if the user has a demand, then trigger to connect to the 5G base station connecting to the 5G cell is enough. Of course, it is introduced through 4G as an anchor point. But if I move out of this area, I can still return to the regular 4G network. This is the advantage of our NSA networking. It does not require a large initial capital investment to build a network. I just need to provide some 5G coverage in some hotspot areas. And another one is our standalone networking scenario. In the standalone networking scenario, we can see that 4G and 5G can be decoupled. Then the 5G base station through the NG interface connect to the 5G core network. Of course, in this scenario, we will find we need a new core network called 5G core. Of course, we can also call it NGC next generation core is also fine. Then at this time, our 5G base station and 5G core network are interconnected through the NG interface. When we see that there are dashed lines and solid lines, then we will have our control plane signaling. There will also be our user plane data finally connected to our 5G terminal. The advantage of this standalone networking is that it can support all scenarios, all application scenarios can be supported, and it can support network slicing. In this way, we can enable vertical industries, but its disadvantage is that we need to build a new 5G core network. Another point is because we are now going to do this standalone networking, I have to do this continuous coverage of 5G that requires us to build more 5G sites at the beginning of construction. In this way, at the beginning of network construction, the investment may be relatively large. So this is also a balance. Actually, it's a balance between effectiveness and reliability. Whether we emphasize our business experience more, then you have to spend a little more money, more investment is needed at the beginning. On the other hand, I might want to save some investment at the beginning, ensure the robustness of the business, I can choose this NSA scenario. So these two scenarios are complementary, but the SA scenario is our target network because it supports slicing to support the needs of vertical industries. So this is our networking scenario, NSA and SA. This SA scenario is our target network. This is our expanded SA network standalone networking architecture. We will see the 5G network. In fact, we said it is a wireless network or called a mobile communication network. This network, we will find it has two parts and it's very similar to 4G. Then the stations below, we call it G NodeB. In fact, its original name is NG NodeB, called Next Generation NodeB. It's just that the name is a bit long than these following sites. We call them G NodeB actually. Its original name was UNG NodeB, which stands for Next Generation NodeB. It's just that this name is a bit long. It was then changed to G NodeB. Of course, we simplify it here as G NodeB. This is the name of our 5G base station, G NodeB. Then the 5G base station is connected to our 5G core network through the transmission network, IP transmission network, connect to our 5G core network. Of course, our 5G core network, we simply call it NGC, Next Generation Core 5G Core Network. Of course, in the 5G core network, we will have different network functions. Of course, these different network functions are deployed on our virtual machines, finally deployed on our x86 servers. We have many network functions. Here are two simple examples. One is called AMF, one is called UPF. AMF is for access and mobility management functions. So it is similar to our control plane. You can simply understand it is used to process some control plane signaling in the core network. UPF is our user plan function. It is our user plane function. Actually, it is to handle our user data, such forwarding and processing. So this is our core network. We simply look at these two functions. One is our control plane. One is our user plane. Our 5G base station needs to connect to the core network. In fact, it needs to connect to both the control plane and the user plane. As we just saw, what does it connect through? The NG interface, right? NGC connects to our control plane AMF. NGU connects to our user plane UPF. In this way, we can achieve the interconnection between the wireless base station and the core network. Intercommunication similarly, on the wireless side, we have many 5G base stations. These different 5G base stations, there is also an interface to achieve interconnection. This interface is called the XN interface. Of course, in the XN interface, it is somewhat similar to our 4G era X2 interface, right? It achieves inter-base station interconnection. Of course, we will combine the base station part together. Call it a wireless access network, right? It's just called NG RAN. It's our next generation wireless access network, radio access network. Because no matter if you have 10 stations or 100 stations, okay, everyone provides wireless access function. We combine these network elements together called the wireless access network. But in 5G, we call it NG RAN, all core network functions. We call it NGC. Sometimes we call the wireless network also called new radio NR. Of course, you can call it new RAN here. Then the core network part is our NGC. In this A network architecture, we will see some interfaces, right? Including our interbase station XN interface between G NodeB stations, GNB, and core network control plane, NGC interface, G NodeB, and our core network user plane, NGU interface. Of course, there is also our air interface, right? It's our 5G terminal, 5G terminal through electromagnetic waves. Connect to our 5G base station. This is our wireless air interface. We call it the UU interface. Of course, this interface name is also used from the 4G era. Even the 3G era interface name, right? From the 3G era, our air interface is called the UU interface. In 4G, we also call it the UU interface. 5G still uses this name, but the protocol of the interface or some details of the interface will be different in the 5G era. Our interface has some enhancements or there are some differences from the 4G era. Okay, this is our 5G target networking method, right? This independent networking, say networking, through this networking method, we can provide slicing capabilities to enable our vertical industries. So we divide the physical network into a slice for the power grid to use. Divide the physical network into a slice for the car company to use. To provide such smart grid services, provide our some vehicle networking services, etc. Okay? This is our SA network architecture.